In this video, we are going to see the various technique of introducing the time delay in microprocessor. The common techniques, the main three common techniques are using one register. It is using a single register, you can set the counter, using a register pair, for example, PC, DE, HL. So using them, you can set a register, can set the counter. And then using loop within loop. So using all the, these three techniques, we can set the time delay. What's time delay? The occurrence of one event and the next event, you introduce a time delay. So after some time only, the next event occurs. So in order to do that, we introduce that time delay. So we will see first using a single register. Let us consider a loop in C++. Say, so for example, C equal to 15, a variable is assigned, and then within the do loop, we are setting while C is greater than 0. So inside the loop, we decrement the counter. Initially, C is 15, then we decrement C minus 1. So now it is 14, and then now you keep, while C here, we check whether it is greater than 0. If it is greater, because now it is C is 14, so it is greater than 0. So again, it go inside and keep continuing, decrementing the counter. So when it becomes 0, we can give here C is greater than or equal to 0. When it becomes 0, it comes out. Or when it becomes minus 1. Okay. So what happens? Automatically, the loop ends and the sentence next to this while will get executed. So this is what we have seen in other languages. Now the similarly we can set the loop similar to this in our microprocessor. So for that, how we are keeping a variable for the as a counting purpose, here we keep the register. Okay, so we can keep the register for as a counter here. So MBI CFFH means this value is moved to the C register. And this takes 70 states. Already we have seen this is a 2-byte instruction and this occupies 2 machine cycles and 70 states. So first machine cycle takes 4 T states and second machine cycle takes 3 T states. Put together 70 states. Then we have to decrement. In the next step, we have to decrement. So similar to this. Then jump on no 0. JNZ is nothing but jump on no 0. So what it will do when decrement takes place, it is an arithmetic operation. So when on doing the decrement, if the register value is equal to 0, then the 0 bit will be set. In flag register, we have the 0 bit. That bit will be set. Till that, it will be 0. But when the C value becomes 0, then that flag bit will be set to 1. So since the 0 bit is, if the 0 bit is not set, then loop. So when the 0 bit will not be set, till it becomes 0, it will not set to 0. So till that, this loop will be executed. So we have given here a JN is at loop. So here it goes, jump, and this statement will be carried over. Imagine here we have, because FF is that, it is nothing but equal to 256. The value is equal to, in decimal, it is equal to 256. So let us imagine we have some 3, MBIC 3. Now what happens? For explanation purpose, I am giving you 3. So when it becomes 3, now here it becomes 2. Jump on no is that. Since it is not equal to 0, the value in C register is not equal to 0. That is, it does not result in 0. So what happened? It goes there. Now it becomes 2. Again, it is not equal to 0. So and so on. It becomes 1, no 0, again 2. Then when it becomes 0, the 0 bit will be set in the flag register. Now what happens? This statement will not get executed. The next statement will be, after this, it quits the loop and the line or the statement which is next to this JN is get executed. Now we'll see that. 70, for this, it is 70 states. And for DC or C, it is a 8-bit instruction. It is 1-byte instruction. So it is 40 states. It's an opcode fetch. and Apgar fetch naturally has 4 T states, one mission cycle. Now this is a 3 byte instruction. J in insert, then loop. Loop is nothing but memory location. The address of this will be placed here, which is nothing but a 16 bit. So it is a 3 byte instruction. So 10 bar 70 state. Why it is 10 bar 70 state? Normally it has 4 mission cycles. The first three, my first cycle will be opcode fetch. The second is the fetching of the higher order address. The second will be the fetching of the lower order address. And finally, executing the statement. Okay, whatever is said in that, that will be executed. So, totally it is 4 mission cycles. But here, 10 bar 7 we have given. So, the last mission cycle will have, the last execution, last jump will have only 3 mission cycles. Because here it fails. It becomes 0. So, it will not jump to this location. So, that thing will be avoided and it goes to the next statement. That is why the last mission cycle is 7. Till that, all other execution of this statement will have 10 T states. So, the first instruction, we will see the explanation of this. The same thing, whatever I have said is written here. The first instruction, usually the loop counter C and is executed only once, requiring only 7 T states. Yes, this is executed only once. After that, it enters the loop. Only this will get executed for F of times. So, the following two instructions form a loop that requires 14 T states. Why 14? 10 plus 4. 14 T states are executed for F of times. They execute and is repeated 255. That is what? F of is equal to 0 to 255. So, 255 times until C becomes 0. So, when it becomes 0, it comes out. So, it is executed for 255 times. So, in order to calculate the delay, we use the following formula. It is nothing but total delay equal to time outside the loop. Okay? And time inside the loop. So, this is the formula. Outside the loop and inside the loop. Together, it gives the time delay of this particular execution of this loop. So, here when you go here, to calculate the delay, we use the following formula. So, which is explained here. Delay outside the loop and delay of the loop. Then, T0 is the sum of all delays outside loop. TL is calculated using the formula. That's now we have seen. So, what happened? T plus loop T states into N. N is nothing but number of iterations, which is given in, which has to be converted into decimal. Here we have given in a hexadecimal. Here we convert it into decimal. So, using the using these formulas, we calculate the time delay for the previous example. So, for 7 T states, how you will calculate T naught, time outside, time delay outside is 7 T states, which is nothing but this. Then loop, within loop it is 14 into 255. Why it is 255? Because equivalent of FF is 255, that is 0 to 255, so 256, but here 0 it comes out, so to proceed 255. So this 14 plus 10 plus 4 are executed for 255 times. That's what here, you know, minus 3. Why? Because the last statement also will be calculated and we subtract minus 3 because the last execution of this J in Z will have only 70 states, only 3 mission cycles. So, we calculate this and subtract and this much of T states are there. So, this plus this together will give you the total time delay of the particular loop. So, if you see that T0 plus TL divided by F, assume that F equal to 2 megahertz means, so it is 1 by F is when you bring it up, it is nothing but 0.5. So, 7 plus, which is nothing but outside and this is the inside loop. 35.67, you have this into multiply by this 0.5 will give you the total time delay of that, which is nothing but 1.787 microseconds. Now, we will see the next one is using two registers, how we can do that.